ladies and gentlemen, the President of the Republic of the Philippines, Rodrigo Roa Duterte. National Housing Authority and the land LWUA to please come here on stage. Lua. Local Water Utilities Administration. Ask the OIC administrator of the Local Water Utilities Administration to please come up front.
I love my country and I love the people of the Philippines.
Pagbabago sawa na ang bayan ko sa nanakaw na trapo. Madilim na kahapon, ikaw ang mag-aahon. Sa piling mo, di ko mawawala ang korupsyon.
You clearly exercise good judgment.
Are you the same age?
Oh my God, he's much older than I am. Oh my gosh.
Mom, I thought you were my first.
Once again, ladies and gentlemen, President Rodrigo Roa Duterte.
Ikaw ang pangulo pagbabago. Sawa na ang bayan ko sa magnanakaw na tao. Madilim na kahapon, ikaw ang mag-aahon. Sa piling mo, di ko mawawala ang korupsyon.
Today, as we do each year on this date, we commemorate and remember those who departed during the Typhoon Yolanda, which took place 3 years ago. To start our program, may we call on Monsignor Rex C. Ramirez, the Vicar General of the Archdiocese of Palo, for the prayer.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, Almighty and ever-living God, we praise and thank you for your kindness and for giving us this beautiful day as a time to gather together and to remember, to seek your mercy, implore your help, and invoke your blessing. Let this gathering of ours mark a new beginning. Let your presence among us enlighten us so that wisdom may be our guide and hope our inspiration. Generously pour upon us your kindness, that we may live in contentment and in health of mind and body. Let the power of your right hand be our strength and protection, that courage may dwell in our hearts and fill our actions. Grant eternal rest to those who lie here. And for those of us who remain, listen to our hearts. In remembering the victims of Super Typhoon Yolanda today, we also pray for the living, in a special way for those who helped us in our time of need and assisted us on the road to recovery. Bless them, Lord, and spare them from evil. Hear too our prayers in behalf of our city, our province, our country, and its leaders, for the unity of all in striving for faithfulness and integrity, in manifesting mutual respect, in laboring for health and prosperity, and in seeking to assure a wholesome and dignified future for our families and the younger generation. And as you inspired and encouraged us to lend our presence here, let your grace accompany each of us on our continuing journey, so that we may travel in peace and security and reach the destination you have prepared for us, where our brothers and sisters await us with all the angels and saints and with Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns forever and ever. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Thank you, Monsignor Ramirez. You may now take your seats. At this point, we would like to call Cabinet Secretary Leoncio B. Evasco Jr. for his message and his presentation to the President of the Consolidated Reports from the three Disaster Risk Reduction and Climate Change Adaptation and Mitigation Summits from September to November 2016.
Rodrigo Roa Duterte, President of the Republic of the Philippines, Leni Gerona Robredo, Vice President of the Republic of the Philippines, fellow workers in government, ladies and gentlemen, maopay na aga han inyo natanan, maapay na hapon. We gather today in a spirit of commemoration in honor of those who died during the onslaught of Typhoon Yolanda. We commemorate the disaster, not because it is the happy occasion, but because we honor not only the memory of those who have gone ahead of us, but also the pain of those who were left behind. The presence of representatives of both the national and local government today, led by no less than the President Rodrigo Rua Duterte himself, is a symbol of this administration's commitment to continue bettering the lives of the people in the Yolanda Corridor. That is why, for the past month, we have been working very closely with key stakeholders in the area to listen, to engage, and collaborate on how we can improve and better the area. We commit to work together to ensure that a catastrophe this great shall never befall us ever again. Mr. President, on behalf of the Cabinet Secretary's Office, the Climate Change Commission, and the Office of the Civil Defense, and together with our partners, the Community of Yolanda Survivors and Partners, Coalition of Yolanda Survivors Association of Tacloban, and the People's Surge, we have the honor to offer to you the results of our consultation, which we hope will form part of government's continued effective interventions in the area. Damo nga salamat, Mr. President. Damo nga salamat ha inyong atanan.
Thank you, Secretary Evasco. May we now call Secretary Judy M. Tagiwalo, Secretary of the Department of Social Welfare and Development, to introduce our guest of honor.
Maupay nga pulop sa aton nga tanan. It is a good afternoon for coming together to remember the victims of Yolanda. I have the honor to introduce to you the man who 3 years ago, on November 10, 2 days after Yolanda devastated the country, particularly Regions 8 and 6, this man sent a convoy of medical teams that included 20 doctors, 20 nurses, and 40 relief workers to help in the massive search and rescue operations. He himself came to Tacloban on November 12, 2013, bringing with him not only 7 million peso cash donation for Tacloban and Leyte, but more importantly, the solidarity of the people of Davao. Now he is back, still in strong solidarity with the victims of Yolanda and with the people of Tacloban and all cities and municipalities devastated by Yolanda. Ladies and gentlemen, the man who is willing to sacrifice his presidency, his honor, and his life to bring about genuine change in the country, President Rodrigo Cadigong Duterte.
Salamat po. Kindly sit down. You know, ganito kahaba ang ipakilala ko. Well, we matter, but what matters most is what has happened 3 years hence. Hindi na lang ako mag-total kilala mo. What is important is gusto ko agad magsalita. Kaya ako ay boarded the truck and called for the guys who has had or who have a thing to work in connection with the Yolanda victims. Alam mo, I came 3 years ago when this incident happened. And I was sad. Ngayon, sinabi ko sa kanila sa truck, hindi ako galit. Do not be offended. But pagtanong ko, 3 years after, ilang tao pa lang ang nakatira sa mga bunk houses or the relief houses that are provided by government. I am not satisfied. As a matter of fact, it's BS to me. 3 years, wala pa'y nakabalhin kaayo. Ano ba rama? Huwag na lang natin ituloy kaya yan. Gawin na lang natin simenteryo. Maghintay tang Yolanda Jr. Alak. Hindi ko kailangan. You know, I just introduced reforms in the national government. In the national offices, irrespective of the department, they are only given 1 month to process the papers. It must be out by 1 month. Ang local government, since you are not under me directly, I do not have the control, but I have the supervision, I will be coming out of rules. That binds everybody, including government corporations. Na kung ganito itong LOA, said, I am, di ako galit sa inyo, itong LOA in its A, DPWH. You do that again, and I will fire all of you. I will ask you to resign. Totoo. Total, may makibigan ko. I mean, dito sa itaas, nakikinig yan. Ang problema sa down in it's not pouring, it's trickling in trickles. And this what I don't know. Alam mo, indolence is part of corruption. When you are paid for 8 hours to do your work, magtrabaho ka ng 8 hours, do not shortchange the public. Now, this 3 years, wala na, 2 years na, and then, we are all Christians. If you read the Bible, it is only God who controls everything, including the reason why we are here. It's mind-boggling, but we do not have the answer. What he proposed to us, at least in the Bible, which says that he will come back here to judge the living and the dead. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Catholic Church. So, about 3 years from now, magbaba na naman si Kristo to judge us, the living and the dead. And the theory is that the dead will rise from itself. I don't know kung saan yan. Maglibingan ba tayo kung mayroon pa? O yung houses na yan, kung hindi pa matapos yung sunod buwan, ay put, gawain mo na lang krematorium yan. Kasi anong sabihin ko dito? What am I supposed to say here? 3 years now has passed, at kayo naghintay na lang ng isa pang tayo na sana pagdating namin dito, wala ng tao para we do not have to say, I am sorry na dumating ng ganito. Really, ako po'y naghihingi ng tawad sa inyo. But for all orders, I have fired so many men in government. It's either magkaintindihan tayo hindi. Ako ho, I propose something like this. I was not elected to sit down there. It was never my ambition to be president. Eh kung nandyan na rin ako, trabaho na lang tayo lahat. Because ako, I never coveted the position. Alam ko lang, alam ninyo, niwala akong isang congressman, wala akong isang governor, except Aimee and Governor Garcia of Bataan and a governor in Mindanao, the only lady, and the only reason why na sinuportahan niya ako, kasi kasintahan ko siya. Ayan ang totoo, hindi ako nagpapatawa. She used or was or girlfriend ko noon. And totoo, nanalo ako, except for Davao. Noon wala akong isang barangay captain sa Central Luzon. That's why the sense of commitment is there, because wala kang pera, wala kang makinarya, and yet the Filipino people gave you an overwhelming mandate to serve. And if this is the kind of service that I came here for, I'm sorry, I said, I do not want to offend anybody. I am not satisfied. Now, 3 years, how many days? I'd like to ask the presidential assistant for the Visayas to Mike Dino. I'll put him in charge. Kaya nga presidential assistant siya, Mike. Magawa ka ng bahay dyan, dyan ka tumira. You oversee the... I want this thing completed. I will be back. Babalik ako. Ano tayo ngayon? October, November. I'll be back December. Mike, gusto ko na... Yan sa harap nila, gusto ko, by December, gusto ko makalipat na lahat. Putak, yung tubig na yan, gawaan mo sila ng swimming pool. Gawaan mo sila ng lahat. Basta, I will be back, I promise you. In the fullness of God's time, I will be back December. Pag wala pa ito sila na lipat dyan lahat, dalhin mo na sa, kumuha ka ng lupa dyan sa Bonifacio o Forbes Park. Bigyan mo yan sila tag isa-isa. So,
yes, sir.
Si commitment, ha?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Para rin, alam mo, Mike, sa totoo lang, bihira ako nagbabaril ng tao, lalo ano kong kaibigan. Pag hindi mo nagawa yan, So you guys, you take your orders, but henceforth, nandito yung sa housing. Nandito si Lenny. She's in charge of the housing. Lahat naman ng ano, next time you take orders from her. And the same order that she's supposed to finish her job on time. Hindi tayo pwede magbilangan, you know, we are so underdeveloped a country that by the nature of the laziness and indolence of some idiots, lalo tuloy tayong naging double the underdeveloped, whatever that phrase means. Kasi di ko talaga na... Kasi kung alam ko lang na wala pa pala tapos at 3 years from now, hindi pa tapos. Sa bagay, mapupunta rin ako dito kasi nandito si Vice President. Kung saan siya nagpunta, nagpasunod-sunod ako. Pero biuda kasi. Annulled man ako sa... Ito to, annulled ako sa asawa. Pero may anak ako. Basta masuportahan lang, okay lang yun. Ma'am, balita ko may... sabi dyan sa ano, huwag kang mahihaan. Do not be offended, pero yung sabi nila, hindi yung totoo. Kaya kung totoo yun, ma'am, may mapatay na congressman na bago. Para mabiyuda uli. You know, maybe the next time I'll sit down with her and some guys from Davao na who were with me for the past 23 years that I was mayor. At baka lang makatulong kami. Hindi namin, I'm not saying that we are the only ones who have the expertise. But in, you know, listening everything, makatulong sila sa input. You know, in I'd come up with a maybe regulations na local government permits should be out. Davao is 3 days. Electrical, business permit, whatever permit, permit to die, the better. Kung ano, basta it has to be only in us. Ako, I do it 72 hours. Any business permit that you'd like to apply, it's 72 hours in Davao. No, walang ano. Then, beyond that, you go to the mayor and explain why you need more than 72 hours to process the papers. For example, if you want to conduct an ocular inspection, you can do that. It will take time. But you have to have some sort of rules for efficiency in this government. Kaya ang itong mga komunista, they tried. And they are correct. Because we have failed miserably just really to govern effectively. Not just govern. Because you are there, you receive your salary. Pero yung tao, alam mo kasi yung taga-gobyerno and even the politicians, pag napanalo sila, nag-iiba ang unanyo, ang isip, they begin to swagger around. Then they go out by bodyguards and all. Tapos they think that they are the special elite chosen by God for that particular epoch. Ganun yan. Nag-iiba, pati yung taga-gobyerno. Instead of just realizing that he is there to help also is para sa kanyang mahirap rin. Ito yung maglabas ng alas 12, magbalik ng alas 3. You know, if you do that, ang akin kasi ngayon, I do not go for any kind of one. It's summary dismissal. Mga police, you begin to fuck your trabaho, hindi kita papalusutin. But, lahat ng police na napasubo sa trabaho, they will have my protection. And I will not allow a single policeman to go to prison just because he was doing his duty. Tandaan ninyo yan. Kayong mga police, wala kayong problema. Basta sa trabaho, either I rise or sink with you. I will not abandon you and I will be there for you. Trabaho lang. Pero pag inaboso yung civilian, ayaw nyo magtrabaho, papasok kayo ng droga, putang ina, papatayin ko talaga kayo. Sa totoo lang, hindi ko kayo palulusutin. I don't give a shit kung sino ka. And that is a warning for everybody. And the new role now, I have somebody listening to remind me. I will return the Alunan Doctrine. The doctrine says that more than 3 bodyguards, including you, kung may armas ka, pangatlo ka, that's a private army. And you will be arrested. Wala akong pakialam kung sinong governor ka o mayor. We go back to the simpler days of, you can have 1 or 2. Ngayon, magdala ka, mag-practice ka. Kung hindi ka marunong magbaril, huwag ka mag-mayor, huwag ka mag-gobyerno. Katalawan mo. Dapat sumali ka na dyan sa nilang. We go back to no more than 2 policemen And it should not be the choice should come from the PNP. Hindi kayo makapili ng tao kasi dyan ang abuso. Ito, bata ito, anak ito ng barangay captain ko. You only have to get it from the service company of the merong, there's a an office there for special units. Kung maghingi ka, only if you are in danger. Kayo namang mga NPA that are nakikinig ngayon, eh kung dalawa lang kasama sa police, huwag ninyong sobrahan. Dalawa lang rin, tabla-tabla yung fight. Ambus-ambus. Ambusin ninyo, tag-isang MRGU. Mga, dalawang police, dalawa kayo. Huwag ninyong sobrahan yung arte na kawawa naman yung kalaban ninyo. I mean, there's no sense in, you know, we're trying our best to come up with something. We are lucky that the, of course, I'd like to thank the Communist Party of the Philippines for giving another try, another shot at the peace process. And kung sakaling, if we succeed, then wala na masyado. Kikita mo, walang patayan. Noong una, ayaw ng military, ayaw ng police kasi NPA. So what do we do? We've been fighting with them for the last 45 years. Sabi ko sa police, sabi ko sa mga military, what? Do you want another 45 years of fighting? Tell us, because if you want then. But you know, the very bullet that I buy to kill you comes from the pocket of the Filipino. Ang gano'n din sa MNLF. Norm Misari came to me and said, we talk again. I said, thank you. Ang MI, I just signed the Bangsamoro Act to replace the BBL. May sabi ni Nor noon, kung walang BBL, he will go to war. And I went to his camp and said, what's the sense? Why? Do you want another 45 years of fighting? Do you really want to kill all of the Boro and the Christians? Is there a way to live a life more half the decency of what we are doing to each other? Sabi ko, mabuti na wala away. But di ba, ang litin mo, Mike, total isang tawagan mo lang man ako sa telepono. There's always the cell phone and you can ask me. And ask everybody to cooperate. Kindly cooperate. Do not delay government projects. Because it would not. Kasi kung ano, magbulahan lang tayo dito, tapos sabihin lang ninyo, ay wala yun, eh, si Duterte, tambalos-los rin yun. Dumaan dito, wala namang. You know, I said, it was never my intention. It was not my ambition to be president. Nandito na ako ngayon. Wala akong, I am not due for any re-election. And besides, this I promise you, I give you my word. I'm hurrying up the federal setup because that is the only thing that could give us enough elbow room to talk to the Moro people in Mindanao if you really want peace and the Communist Party of the Philippines. Yang dalawang yan, which is the two main pressure groups in our society today, ng kailangan nila inyo set up. Anak ko naman, I said mas mabuti yan. But provide a federal set up with a strong president. Otherwise, kung parliament pure, I do not think because of the diversity of in so many aspects, it would not be good. You would need a strong president. I am not eligible anymore. I'm only good for 6 years. But if you can craft it in about 2 to 3 years' time, I'd be happy to step down. Okay na ako. Sibat na ako. Basta tingnan ko lang, I will just maybe husband it from its gestation hanggang its... And if you can call an election 4 years from now under a federal setup, I think it would be good for everybody. So with that message, please do not be again offended by my... Talagang medyo, hindi ako galit. I'm not... malaman ninyo ako galit kasi mag... Sige lang akong... Pag ako ang galit, sige lang ako nagtingin ng magagandang babae. Kaya ganun talaga, si Ma'am Lenny, binibiro ko yan. When the, you know, when the talks get boring and the argument starts, I always interject a joke para to make it more, pero totoo talaga. Nung una sa meeting, the arrangement, mas magkatabi kami. Sabihin ko kaya, Ma'am, oh. Hindi ka magano. Kasi si Ma'am Lenny, medyo shorter than usual yung damit na, ano. Siguro nahalata ng mga protocol officer. Sige ako sa likod. Sunny Dominguez naman. Sabi ka, layo mo dito. Kaya dito tayo ulit ka. Sabi ko. Tingnan mo yung tuhod ni... Nung alahalata niya, sige na siya. Gusto ko sabihin, Ma'am, mag-shorts ka na lang kaya. Huwag itong piksi-iksi ka ng damit na boss. So, anong ginawa ng gaging, inulit niya hindi yung pag-anon. So, dito, magkita mo man, binaliktad niya, tapos nakaharap na doon. Wala ng view. So, nung next mga after 3 may cabinet meetings, doon na siya sa harap ko. Malayo ang tingin. Maraming salamat.
Thank you very much, Mr. President. This concludes our third year Yolanda commemoration activity. May we request everyone to give way for the President as he leaves for his next engagement. Thank you, everyone, and thank you, President Rodrigo Roa Duterte.
Yung nakalimutan ko yung but she reminded me si secretary tigwalo sa DSSD sa emergency assistance of 5,000 lahat kayo makatigim 5,000 makatanggap brother.
Thank you sir. Thank you. Thank you.
pag-asa, pagbabago. Sawa na ang bayan ko sa magnanakaw na tao. Madilim na kahapon, ikaw ang mag-aahon. Sa piling mo, di ko mawawala ang korupsyon. Tayo na, Pilipinas, tayo na magbago. Hawak kamay tayo para sa pag-asenso. Ikaw at ako, tayong
lahat. Pero naidungang di ay plus kang DTI si Secretary Ramon Lopez
livelihood assistance
3 that makes 8 ongoing lang iya 5,000 so that's about 10,000. I hope you yung mga 3,000 sa tuba ganon, yung 2,000 siyabo siguro. Pero matay ko. Baski saan mo tago ng inayayarin ko kayo.
Sige, boss. Oh, safe trip. Hindi na sila
because I love my country and I love the people of the Philippines.
Ikaw at ako, tayong lahat kay Rodrigo. Together, para sa tunay na pagbabago.
Itong aid ko, huwag kayo magluko-loko ha, kay Tagarito ito. Yun. Tagarito ito. Kasi yung magturo sa akin kung sino yung mga bad girls.
Para sa